Hello friends, welcome to my channel Local Guy. Today I am going to show you how to configure WDS wireless distribution system or wireless bridge on DDWRT based routers. So here is the scenario. Here is my main router, which is TP-Link TD-W8970. Its IP address is 192.168.1.1 and Wi-Fi network SSID is Falcon 1. Here is my extender router on which I have flashed the TDWRT firmware. Now I want to connect DDWRT router to my main router wirelessly using WDS bridge to extend my Wi-Fi range. If your old router does not support wireless repeater, range extender or WDS, then try flashing it with TDWRT firmware. TDWRT provides more features with many settings to the router. Friends, I have made many videos on how to connect two routers. You can check the videos on my channel. But this video is different. Here, both routers use different firmware. Main router running on TP-Link firmware and extender router running on third-party TDWRT firmware. It's like we are connecting two different brand routers. So if you want to connect two different brand routers, then watch the video till the end so you can understand how WDS works on different brand routers. Before starting the video, if you have not subscribed to my channel, then please subscribe first and press the bell icon for new video notification. Friends, you can also browse my channel for more useful videos. So, without wasting time, let's start the video. First, connect the DDWRT router to the computer using LAN cable. Connect LAN cable to LAN port of the router. By default, DDWRT router IP address is 192.168.1.1. So let's change computer IP address to same subnet to access the router. So setting computer IP address to 192.168.1.2. Now open the browser and type 192.168.1.1. As this is first time login, let's change the username and password. On stock firmware, routers like TP-Link, D-Link, Tanda, etc., it is easy to configure WDS. But DDWRT is third-party firmware. We have to do some manual settings to make it work as WDS bridge. So let's do it. First, disable the WAN port as we want to connect this router to the existing Wi-Fi network. WAN port is used when we want this router to connect to the ISP. On TP-Link, D-Link, Tanda or any other routers, by changing the mode to range extender or bridge mode, it will automatically disable the WAN port. Here on DDWRT, we have to do it manually. Then enable the HTTP spanning tree protocol. Now change the router's default IP address. Set the IP address from the same subnet as the main router. IP address must be unique and not used by any device on the network. For that, log into your main router and under DHCP, note down the start IP address and end IP address. Apply the IP address from this range. Here I have set it to 192.168.1.150. In gateway, enter the IP address of your main router. Here it is 192.168.1.1. In DNS, also keep the same IP address. Now disable the DHCP server as we want the main router to act as a DHCP server. Remove all the checkmarks below, then save the settings. Now go to advanced routing and change the operating mode to router, then save the settings. Now go to services and disable the DNS mask and WAN traffic counter daemon, then save the settings. Now go to security and disable the SPI firewall and save the settings. Now go to wireless and select wireless mode as access point. Keep the same Wi-Fi channel as main router. Here my main router uses channel number 11, so setting it to 11. You can change the Wi-Fi network SSID name or keep it same as the main router to use as repeater and save the settings. Now go to wireless security and select the same security settings as the main router. Here I am selecting network authentication, WPA2 personal and algorithm AES. Click save and set the password. You can use the same password as the main router or change to any. I am changing it to time 2222 and save the settings. Now go to WDS and under Wireless MAC, select LAN and enter the main router's MAC address. And save the settings. Then apply the settings. Router will reboot to take effect all the settings. Now login to the main router. Then go to Wireless, under Wireless, enable WDS. A new settings will open. Enter the SSID name and BSSID, it means MAC address of the extender router. Or you can click on scan and select the AP name of the extender router. Here it is DDWRT. Click on connect. Now select key type WPA2 personal and encryption AES. Enter the password of the extender router network. Here it is time 2222 and save the settings. Remember, here to make WDS work on two different brand routers, then both routers must know each other's BSS ID, it means MAC address, and one of the routers must know the Wi-Fi network password of the other router, so they can authenticate each other. Here, in our scenario, we have manually provided the MAC address of both the routers to each other. On the main router, we have also entered the password of the extender router, so we have done all the settings. Now login to the extender router and under status you can see the MAC address of the main router. So router has successfully authenticated each other. Now let's check if internet connection is working or not. And yes, you can see that internet is working on extender router. Friends, if wireless link between the two routers disconnected by some reason, then you don't have to restart the extender router manually. Thanks to DDWRT firmware, just enable WDS watchdog and enter the interval and IP address of primary router. So extender router will check the link status by sending keep alive messages to primary router. Here we have set the interval of 300 seconds. So every 300 seconds, extender router will check the link status. If keep alive message is not received, then extender router will reboot itself and will try to establish the link again. This is very useful feature. If you have connected a number of routers using WDS bridge, you don't have to restart each router manually. Friends, if your device like TV, desktop PC or game console has no built-in Wi-Fi functionality and the only way to access the internet is via Ethernet port, in that scenario, the router will act as Wi-Fi adapter. It means you can also access the internet using router's LAN port. Just plug the LAN cable between router's LAN port and your device Ethernet port, and you are ready to access the internet. As I have said earlier, DDWRT has many features. If you are running out of LAN port, then you can convert WAN port to LAN port. Just enable assign WAN port to switch. Now this router has all LAN ports, just like a network switch with Wi-Fi access point. So that's it for today. I hope you understand how WDS works on two different brands or two different firmware routers. Thanks for watching the video. If you have any query about the settings, please ask in the comments. Like, share and subscribe to the channel. Till then, goodbye.